everyone! In this video, we are going to make a DIY safe locker similar to the one that is used in homes. For making the locker, you will need evive, corrugated sheets, a servo motor, servo horns, servo screw, and a straw. Let's begin by making the parts of the safe box. Take a yellow corrugated sheet of dimension 30 by 15 cm and draw a line in the center. Now cut along the line. The two halves will be the top and the bottom of the box. Then take a red corrugated sheet of dimension 60 by 15 cm and draw three lines each at a distance of 15 cm. Cut along the lines only through the first layer of the corrugated sheet. Then fold the sheet along these lines. These will act as the side walls of the locker. Now let's give the locker a door. Draw a square of 10 by 10 cm on the front side of the locker. Cut along the three sides of the square. And at the back of the fourth side, make a small cut only through the first layer of the sheet. This will create a hinge structure that will make the opening and closing of the door smooth. Now let's make the handle for opening the door. Draw a small circle on a piece of corrugated sheet and cut it out. Then take a straw and cut a piece of 1 cm. Take a small strip of yellow corrugated sheet and fold it such that it forms a U-shaped structure. This will act as a part of the interlocking mechanism of the box. Now let's assemble the locker. Take the first half of the 30 by 15 cm yellow corrugated sheet and paste three of the side walls of the locker perpendicular to it using hot glue. Then attach the handle to the outer side of the door and the U-shaped structure to the inner side. Now let's complete the interlocking mechanism. For that, we first need to set the servo angle. Bring in evive and connect the servo motor to the S2 channel. Then switch it on and from the menu select controls, then servos, then servo 2. Set the servo angle to 90 degrees using potentiometer 2 and then disconnect it. Now take one single sided servo horn and one double sided servo horn and attach them to the servo head using a 20mm servo screw. Paste the servo motor at back of the door using hot glue. Make sure that it interlocks properly with the U-shaped structure. Now, paste the fourth sidewall using hot glue. Next, connect the servo motor to evive servo channel 2. Then write the code in PictoBlox and upload it to evive. The program will run when evive starts up. The door should open when we slide the slide switch upwards. Otherwise, it should remain closed. Now let's complete the locker assembly. Take the second half of the 30 by 15 cm yellow sheet and paste it on the top of the box. You can add another level of security by making the locker password protected. For making the locker password protected, a few changes needs to be done to the script. First, set the password. Then program evive such that the password can only be entered when the slide switch is down. The door will still remain locked. Now, the potentiometer gives value between 0 to 1023 and our password can vary between 0 and 100. So, we are going to use a map function to map the potentiometer readings to values between 0 and 100. The next if else statement controls the interlocking mechanism. Only if the entered password and the set password are the same and the slide switch is up, the servo angle will set to 100 degrees and the door will open. The message "Access granted" will also be displayed on the screen. Otherwise, the servo angle remains to 0 degrees and the door will remain locked. An evive screen will display access denied. With this, your password protected locker is ready. Guys, if you like this video, share it with your friends and don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Let us know what you'd like us to make next in the comment section below. And for more such interesting projects, subscribe to STEMpedia and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. See you soon.